Tom Rolander, 2013 Entrepreneurial Excellence Diamond Award winner.
Tom defines entrepreneurship. Tom did it because he loved it.
I could hire one Tom and he could do the work of three engineers. I mean, he's unbelievable.
I mean, what else can you say about somebody who has run 100 marathons?
He's done more startups than all of us put together.
I remember Tom talking about was the very early days in the labs at UW, working half the night, programming. He talks about that experience, that feeling of actually making this stuff work. It's really characteristic of what he brings to anything he's involved with.
When he came here to the University of Washington to graduate school, he met this guy here by the name of Gary Kildall, who really was then a kindred spirit. Both of them had these incredible ideas. They became lifelong friends, and the things that the two of them did really laid the foundation. They planted the seeds for what later became known as the computer or personal computer revolution.
Tom worked at Fluke and Intel and later joined Gary Kildall at Digital Research, where they created one of the earliest and most influential operating systems for microcomputers.
Tom was a pioneer, and his greatest innovations has been in taking microprocessors and turning them into general purpose computers. Remember, the maximum memory then was 64,000 bytes. And Tom produced the underlying software to allow multiple programs to run independently on one of these computers, and then extended that to networking through what we called at the time CPNet. Apple and Microsoft didn't really have multitasking till the 90s. He was 20 years ahead of what other people did.
After Digital Research, Tom and Gary went on to create KnowledgeSet, one of the earliest examples of multimedia pushing the boundaries of interactive hardware and software.
And they developed then on CD-ROM the first electronic encyclopedia for Grolier.
Tom went on to co-found the software company PG Soft.
And at that time, there were a bunch of utilities that were coming out for like disk compression and antivirus and security. So we rode that wave and created a bunch of different utilities, one of which was called Gimme Space, which was basically, you know, reducing disk space and offering compression. Another, believe it or not, that was called SaveButt. So it was a controversial name that we created, but it actually, if you accidentally deleted something, we'd be able to bring it back. And then the final title that we built actually was a precursor to what people would know today as iCloud. Tom came up with this idea of synchronizing data between any device you used, your laptop, your home machine, any device, that all your data would be there and automatically synchronized. It was way ahead of its time. And then we ended up selling the company to Novell as a result of that title. And they call it iFolder. And it's still a very popular application for Novell.
Tom then worked at Sony as a consultant, designing authoring software for the data disk man that used mini CDs to store books.
And so it really, again, laid the foundations for a lot of the electronic books and things like that that we have today.
Tom's fifth startup was a company called Crossloop.
So Crossloop's a great example of Tom's ability to create clearly superior software. So Crossloop worked on the problem of one computer across the internet controlling another, and doing it in a way that was highly reliable and completely transparent. Sounds easy? But you've got firewalls, you've got all kinds of protocols, and I think he had the state of the art in that kind of technology.
Recently, Tom has become involved in a different kind of entrepreneurial venture, Ecopia Farms, an innovative urban indoor farm leading the next generation of agricultural sustainability in California.
He is setting up a back office suite as an example so that we can have data acquisition and have process control. He's setting up the whole shop floor control and shop floor planning system, and he's also doing the front end forecasting things for us. So because of his background and ability to do this thing, he's a very valuable person. And on top of that, because of his can-do attitude, he's helping us develop the right kind of culture for a startup.
He saw a way to really change the world, to give people computer power and put it in their hands. And, you know, he loved it. He made a difference.
He's used all his engineering background. I think he brings honor to University of Washington's engineering department.
He really is a lifetime member of the community whose work has laid the foundation upon which other people then have built skyscrapers.